The common carotid artery. There are two common carotid arteries in our body. One is on the left and another one is on the right. And these arteries originate from different arteries but follow asymmetrical courses. As you can see, the right common carotid artery, which is a branch of the brachiocephalic artery, and it begins in the neck behind right sternoclavicular joint. But whereas the left one, that is the left common carotid artery, is a branch of arch of aorta, and the common carotid artery is enclosed in the carotid sheet on both the sides. And what about the course? The common carotid artery begins in the thorax in front of the trachea, opposite a point a little to the left of the center of the manubrium, and it ascends to the back of the left sternoclavicular joint and enters the neck. And in the neck, both arteries have similar course. So each artery runs upwards within the carotid sheet under the cover of the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and it lies in front of the lower four cervical transverse processes. As you can see in this picture, at the level of the upper border of the thyroid cartilage, the artery ends by dividing into external as well as internal carotid arteries. Now let us talk about relations of the artery in the neck. And first is about the anterior relations. The common carotid is crossed by the superior belly of the omohyoid at the level of the cricoid cartilage. And below the omohyoid muscle, the artery is deeply situated, and it is covered by the sternocleidomastoid, the anterior jugular vein, the sternohyoid, and the sternothyroid, as well as the middle thyroid vein. All these are the anterior relations of the common carotid artery. And what about the posterior relations? The posterior relations are transverse process of the vertebrae C4 to C8, and the muscles attached to their anterior tubercle, like longus coli, longus capitis, and scalenus anterior. And also another important structure which is related posteriorly is the inferior thyroid artery, which crosses medially at the level of the cricoid cartilage and the vertebral artery. And on the left side, the thoracic duct is the one which crosses laterally behind the artery, exactly at the level of C7 vertebrae in front of the vertebral vessels. And what are the medial relations? The medial structures are the thyroid gland, larynx, pharynx, trachea, esophagus, and the recurrent laryngeal nerve. All these are the structures which form medial to the common carotid artery. And the lateral relation is internal jugular vein, and posterolateral is the vagus nerve. All these are the relations of the common carotid artery. What is the clinical anatomy which is related to the common carotid artery? This artery is extremely important for the pulsation that can be felt by compressing against the carotid tubercle, that is the anterior tubercle of the transverse process of the vertebra of C6, which lies at the level of the cricoid cartilage. And by this we completed the anatomy of common carotid artery.